Good day, fellow investors. Welcome to the stock market news with a long-term fundamental twist. This week, the news was mostly about trade wars, tariffs, Trump's actions, Trump's negotiations, and how that might impact the stock market. And even the stock market declined a bit over the last week. However, perhaps as you're watching this news, perhaps there would be a trade deal, a positive one, a negative one, who knows, retaliation, nobody knows what will happen. And I want to put that into an investing context so that you can know what are the best investment decisions to make in this environment. So the topics will be, and I think we'll start with the most important piece of information that was distributed by the media over the last 10 days, and that is Warren Buffett's, Charlie Munger's and Bill Gates's interview with Becky Quick for CNBC. And we're going to summarize a little bit that because they really touched on China, on that kind of news, and they tell you everything you need to know about investing. So after that, I'm going to show you an incredible picture that will blow your mind, and it is related to what Buffett is saying about how to invest. And after that, we're going to focus on something they mentioned, but it is second grade news for the media because it's long-term news, but we're going to focus on monetary policy, continuing on what we started discussing with Ray Dalio's monetary policy free video that I made last week. So let's start on the trade wars. Warren Buffett was pretty clear on this. So he says it is ridiculous. Just think of it as the US would have different state laws so that a state can impose a tariff on another state. So, I don't know, Michigan would put a state tariff on cars, etc. So, if you put the same perspective on the global trade war, you see how ridiculous it is. However, Buffett's message is, okay, think of where will the world be 10, 5, 20 years from now, not about what will be the political predominant, let's say, idea until the next elections. Munger is very clear on trade, and he says that it is normal business. It happened with Japan 20 years ago on truck tariffs, car tariffs, etc. So it is something normal, something that we have to simply take as granted, and then think how we invest in businesses and businesses evolve alongside tariffs, and all the businesses Buffett and Munger own simply adjust to that. Also, Bill Gates was discussing how there are new rules, new regulations, and a business adjusts. And while I was researching businesses, I'm currently researching businesses in Asia. I did a dozen or so last week, and I found a very good example of showing how a business is flexible and it's a dynamic entity, not a fixed entity so that it can be hit by trade wars, etc. I found this company, I was researching, I'm still researching, I still have to write the full report, but it's called Manhwa. And it is the largest Chinese sofa producer, and 40% of their revenue comes from the US. So if there are trade tariffs, okay, this company would be destroyed. However, as soon as Trump got elected a few years ago, what did they do? They have a lot of production facilities in China, some in Europe for the European market, but as soon as there were trade talks, trade issues, they started to build a new production facility in Vietnam. So the target market here is the US, huge production capacity. So they will be able to perhaps export from China to Vietnam and then to the US, or simply produce things here or assembly the sofas here and send them to the US without tariffs. And this is a perfect example of how businesses are dynamic entities and how you always have to think that things will change over time for the business, in the environment, and if that you invest in a good business with good management, that's all you need to do, especially if you can do it at a fair price. And the tariffs, all the commotion that has pushed down Chinese stocks might give you great opportunities to buy great businesses in a great environment. And as I promised, I'll show you now the picture that is simply mind-blowing. Just look at this, the population of Asia and Oceania in 2018. China, okay, 1.5 billion, but the total population there is 4.5 billion. So on top of China, you have another, 3.2 billion people. 1.3 billion in India, Bangladesh, 160 million, Pakistan, 200 million, Iran, 82 million, Turkey, 82 million, Afghanistan, I think it was 40 million, something like that, a little bit less. So Vietnam, 96 million, Thailand, Malaysia, Indonesia, 266 million people, Philippines, 90 million, South Korea, 50, okay, Japan, 127. So these numbers are mind-blowing. So that's 4.5 billion people, not even including Russia, who is with its biggest part in Asia. And if you think, okay, where will this environment be in 20 years? Then you know, okay, these tariffs are really, really something small when you put them into the big, big investing picture. So the investing message is, if Trump does more crazy things, if there is retaliation, if there is pain on the stock market, go and look for those cheap businesses, because that might be the opportunity of your life in this 4.5 billion market environment. We have Indonesia growing at 6%, Philippines growing at 5%. So, okay, they're going to, I don't know, buy sofas, but then you go bottom up and you look at individual business opportunities that go margin of safety, value investing, good business yield, growth, etc., smart management, and then you make an investment decision. What happens with Trump? What happens with this, with that? That's just leave it for the media and invest like Buffett and you will do great. And something I want to conclude this news is, there at the end of the interview with CNBC, they discussed monetary policy. And all of them, Gates, Munger, and Buffett, gave really clear insights onto what they think about the current state of the monetary policy and interest rates, which is something to keep in mind when it comes to investing. And Buffett said in his conference call last week, invest in productive assets. And that's something that I am reiterating here. Let's see what they said. On monetary policies, Gates said that he is amazed at how high the valuations are, but that's logical as interest rates work like gravity on asset prices. However, Munger said that he is afraid of the idea that you can just print money and solve all your problems. That will eventually fail. Print too much money and you will end up something like Venezuela. And here, Munger, I like him, I love him, because he's so direct, he tells you how things are. So if you listen to Munger, you will know how things are. And that's why we, at least on this channel, adore really Munger, because that's truth and he doesn't like lies. And then on Buffett, he said, 10 years ago, I thought low unemployment, 5% deficits, growing deficits and bond rates at 3% would be impossible. And then he said, if I feel something is impossible, it's going to change over time. So it looks like the promised land, money doesn't cost anything, you can print lots of it, no unemployment and no inflation. I still believe you can have low interest rates, high deficits, low inflation for a long period of time. But so far, I am wrong. And then he said how stocks are ridiculously cheap if we still have a 3% 20-30 year bond and then comparable, and if that keeps going on like that for the next 10-20 years, then stocks, yes, are cheap. But as he says, he thinks it will change. Charlie Munger thinks it will change somewhere down the road. So it is a risk we have to keep in mind when investing, and you can be protected by what Buffett is doing, by simply buying productive assets that can increase prices in case of inflation. So thank you for watching. Looking forward to your comments. Subscribe to this channel if you like this investing style, in business investment style orientation, when we focus bottom up on businesses, we look what's going on in the macro, but we try to get to the best info out there so that we can find the best businesses that will survive, do great, give us great returns no matter what. I'll see you in the next video.